Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to the Offspring. And it is a request of our patron Dan R. We are going to react to the song The Kids Aren't Alright. The Kids Aren't Alright. I like the take of the Offspring on topics. We have reacted to a couple of songs of theirs and I was impressed by the music, by the vocals, by the subject, the way they cover it. I like it. So this time it should be very interesting to see what they are talking about with the title like this, The Kids Aren't Alright.
Yeah, and people have given a very good response to those reactions too. So let's listen to what is going on with the kids in this one or in this song of Offspring. What is their take on it? Why aren't the kids alright? Is it Copa? Copacabana. Anyway. Similar to the earlier two songs in the music arrangement and the vocals. So, if it was released in the 90s, how different it is 30 years later, 2019, close to 2020. Wow, this is beautiful. This is an evergreen song of this generation. It's a masterpiece. It is so hard-hitting from the word go. It's pulsating, energetic, relentless, rocking sound, you know, from the song, from these guys, the Offspring. They are phenomenally talented. I wish they were around today. I don't
still
know if they
music,
are.
Yeah.
I really wish they were around because this is a class act that we just heard. Yeah. A class act. Great sound, great vocals and what a storyline, what strong, powerful lyrics that, you know, I'm in India, I'm in Mumbai. I may not necessarily have grown up in those kind of environment,
same
in that
streets,
kind of
yeah.
town or city, but I can completely get what they're saying because it has become this way today. So I get exactly what they're talking about, and in fact it's much worse in most parts of the world. This is beautiful. Fragile lives, shattered dreams. It, that line says it all, doesn't it? Wow, nothing's free really. You know, how what a wonderful life there. What are your thoughts anyway? Before I get to
I absolutely enjoyed the song. I love the vocals. One more time, the Offspring made a mark on me. Impressive, impressive and impressive all the way. I would call it a masterpiece, and I think all the whatever songs that we have heard, they are all masterpieces in their own right. I like the selection of the topics being so relatable, so connectable and so much in the real time. No fiction, no story, nothing, very hard hitting and very real, and this is how they have had so far with me. I don't know the rest of the catalog, but I like what I've heard so far, and I like the music a lot. It's from the word go. It is great music all the way. When rock is mixed with purpose, it becomes purposeful rock, and the people who listen to it, their lives will be also purposeful. It wouldn't be someone who OD'd and died, and someone who committed suicide, and it wouldn't be somebody who gave up on their dreams. If they listen to songs like this, I'm sure they will be motivated to do something better with their lives. Having said that, you know, I understand personal approach and putting your individual effort towards your life, not giving up, not falling into the traps of vices, the drugs and addictions and other things that can affect your life badly. But I also, you know, equally think what is responsible for miserable lives of a lot of people is the fact that so many good things are always with a hefty price to pay. So the poor and the people who don't have enough money, they are already and automatically eliminated out of this elite league, what only the people who are born with a lot of money can enjoy. Whether it is good quality of education, whether it is good facilities for medical, etc., whether it is good hobbies and all, they only are supposed to be and meant to be for the people who can afford it. And the people who fall short of the funds for all of this, they don't have other options. Where are they supposed to go? What are they supposed to do? They feel bitter and they feel betrayed and they feel rejected. That why they can't have the same things, same hobbies, same kind of lifestyle what the people with money can afford. The good food and good quality of food also is denied to people who are poor in this time, which is all their rights. Good food, clean air, clean water, good education is the rights of everybody, whether it is with money or with no money. Both the people are supposed to get it. But how equally it is distributed, you and I know, and how difficult it is, you and I know. When it comes to basic education, I know most countries do their part in giving it more or less free, you know, making it affordable for people. But when it comes to real testing, apart from the basic education, we need the professional education, professional degrees to do well and survive in this life. Whether you want to become a doctor, engineer, something that you can take up after that professionally. When it comes into that game, it's all about the money. It's all about selling those degrees instead of literally giving it to the people who are credible enough or who can actually do something in that field.
If you talk about the song, we'll... You can continue with what you're saying, but just to stay on topic, it's about a street. It's about a street in a town or city, perhaps in America, considering that the Offspring is from America.
Yeah.
So it's about that and how one point of time they had a wonderful childhood, no burdens, no responsibilities.
No,
they lived a carefree life. They were so close. They thought the future was going to be just amazing.
Right.
But then as they grew up, they realized that it's not as rosy as they dreamed of when they were younger, and things just fell apart, and there were so many stories of course he's given just a few examples, but if you look at it in a cluster of cities, towns in America or even most parts of the world today, it is a phenomenal thing. It is a major problem, you know, whether you take drugs, whether you take suicide, whether you take unemployment, whether you take the inequality of classes. Just one statistic that people may not know about who are watching this reaction is that one country, in this case America, there is practically 99% of the population, the wealth of 99% of the population is equal to the wealth of 1% of the population. So when you have that kind of disparity and discrimination and inequality in the classes, what do you expect? The middle class is non-existent. They don't have the power. The middle classes are the ones who actually have the purchasing power, the buying power, which creates employment, which creates a lot of millions of jobs, millions of sales, billions, trillions of sales. So if that class is non-existent or is diminishing rapidly, you really can't expect much. It's not that you can see what is really going on, because you still have a wealthy class and they are doing phenomenally well for themselves. But when 99% of the country is suffering, and it's not just about America, we have statistics for America, so we can talk more about it. But even in India, it's more or less kind of similar. In many other countries, it's kind of similar. So it's a what foresight? Basically, what I want to say and why I interrupted Kirti is because we don't have too much time. What incredible foresight of the Offspring. They wrote a song back in the 90s probably, but how relevant and amazing it is today. Listening to it, it literally feels like, wow. If this song was released today, December 28th, 2019, I'm telling you, this would have been a great song, much bigger than what it was. I would have probably heard about it if it was that big back then.
Yeah.
At least worldwide. Maybe it was big in a large part of America. But what good is that when the whole world needs music like that today? So if it was released today, I promise you this song would make waves. It would hit the radios. It would be on the phones of people across the world, especially the young ones, because every single young one, whether rich or poor or middle class, will connect with these lyrics today more than then. More than then. More than back then. Wow. Okay, Kirti, anything you'd like to say or to continue with whatever you were saying?
What I was saying is basic. You know, people are just trapped and people are just manipulated and misled into all these systems which tell them you are not good enough to get an admission into this institute. You are not good enough to get into admission into this elite institute of medicine or engineering or technology. But I think it should be beyond that. You make up seeds for the kind of population you have, the young generation you have. The people want to learn. Let them in and teach them something. Don't put a price tag on those services. Instead of putting the price tag, put a more focus on how much you're educating people, not how much you're going to make in returns with the limited amount of people that you take and more money extraction from them. Don't have a transaction in that. Education has to be free, and especially higher education as well. Everybody has the right to learn so that they can survive and they can serve the society in return. I hate the higher level education deals that happen.
But is it only education, Kirti, that is causing all these problems, ODing? I mean, if you just take one of these issues mentioned here,
yeah.
Teenage pregnancy is of course a large issue by itself.
Yeah.
People, girls and even guys, you know, I mean, the girls getting pregnant and guys getting into a relationship much sooner than it probably should have happened.
Mm-hmm.
So teenage pregnancies is of course a big issue in so many countries of the world. We know it's a big issue in UK,
yeah.
Canada as well as America,
mm-hmm.
and in India also.
Yeah.
But the biggest issue right now, one of the biggest, is the the inequality of class and drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Drugs is, you know, it's so common that it's almost all over today. Whether it's movies, TV shows, parties, anything really that is happening socially with the younger generation, most of the younger generation, it does involve or talk about drugs or actual taking consumption of drugs. And it's kind of funny because it's shocking, but it's also kind of funny because it's supposed to be illegal. You're not really supposed to, apart from few cities and places of the world, it's not supposed to be sold on the streets or over the counter anywhere.
That's how it is.
So the fact is that since it's such a big issue, how come it is become this way. So is it only purely education?
It's not just
or lack of education. What is the other thing? Isn't poverty the main issue? Poverty, the people don't have money.
I'll tell you, it's
you know, they don't have much to do. They take to drugs because that's an outlet for them.
It's the handicapped structure of the government bodies that they pretend to work very hard, but they don't really tap into the real issues. They don't really care. They just need to show people that we are working very hard for you, but it's like looking busy, doing nothing. Kind of syndrome all over the world into the government organizations that leads to the society being as it is and facing all the problems that they face on a daily basis. That's how it is.
Okay, so we've had a discussion about the topic, great song, great music, wonderful vocals, just a masterpiece I feel it is. Amazing song. I really hope that this kind of music and this kind of songs are re-released. You know, this needs to be get out there. Songs like that need to get out there, get all over the world, not just America, but all over the world. It shouldn't be restricted to one zone or country. This kind of music the whole world needs right now. And I really, really say, with a lot of experience, knowledge, I'll definitely say, this song released today would have been a worldwide hit, because this is what is the need of the hour. It's great music, sung beautifully, but also such a pertinent topic taken up in a wonderful way in just 2 minutes. Two and a half minutes.
Thank you for watching.